Where's the song?
Oh, boy.
Where's the song?
Oh, no.
Your daily hour with me. Maybe.
Hi, and welcome to your daily hour with me. I'm your host, Charles McDonald, and joining alongside me are the three people who are in charge of your daily hour with me, Rick, Regan, and Carl.
Regan's in charge.
You're in charge.
Yeah.
Charles is not in charge.
Anyway, welcome to all three of you. We're glad to have you with us.
Now tell me
something here. What got you interested in going into working on your daily hour with me for TCTV?
Wow, we're getting right into it real fast with the interviews and stuff. We gotta like ease our way into this, don't you think?
Right to the heart.
Should we start off doing something before we get like into the meat of it? Maybe? No? Because if we start off with the meat, like where are we gonna go? We gotta have appetizers, you know?
Yeah, you're saying we should go in for appetizers there?
Appetizers, like metaphorical, like speaking appetizers, because if we start asking like the big questions, like you started off with the big question, I think we should just say like, hey, how are you? Let's say how are you first. I like to say how are you first.
You like to say how are you?
Yeah, how are you?
Kenny still has to host.
Oh, sorry.
Apparently.
Yeah,
apparently Kenny just has to host.
Yeah, I'm going
to
stop hosting. Charles
is going on.
Viewers, I just okay, I'll just say something to the viewers because we started off like this though, but viewers, we're doing this thing today, so Charles is going to do it, so let's, you know, we can actually start over for real, but we can pretend start over. So yeah, look at that. Okay, go for it, Charles, you do it now. I'll give it back to you, sorry.
Yeah!
I'm going to take a back seat. Okay, there you go.
Anyway, hi, I'm Charles McDonald, and joining alongside me is the three people who are in charge of your daily hour with me. Yeah, we're glad to have them all here. Yeah, say hello to Rick, Regan, and Carl.
Hi.
Welcome to all three of you. We're glad to have you join us today. Yeah,
and my pleasure.
Who's we?
Anyway, how are the three of you doing so far?
Oh, good. Thanks for asking.
I'm very depressed.
Oh, depressed? How come you're depressed, Carl?
I got the deer in the lights of I've probably done like 1,000 episodes on your daily hour with me, and
that's why I'm depressed.
Yeah, there's no higher from this point. You know, it's all downhill from here. It's all downhill from here.
Just wait.
just wait and see because your daily hour with me and working on television might perk you up a little bit.
Yeah, Carl.
Okay, I'll take a swig of that, Joe.
Just write it out.
That coffee.
When you ask, I mean, we're not saying anything, but are you gonna ask this question, so?
Yes, I will. Anyway, what got you three interested in working in television?
I was actually watching TCTV. I've been participating in TCTV since I was a little kid, but I saw the channels, you know, flipping through the channels back in the day when you could flip through the channels, you know, because it goes so slow these days. You can't really flip. You gotta use a guide or something. Back when you could just flip, and I came across a channel that was just like bunch of words, and it said maybe like what was on lunch, maybe for lunch at school, and I was like, oh, I want to see what's I'm gonna eat for lunch or something. So I started watching the thing, and then I saw the thing. It said, like, excuse me. It said you could be on TV. Go to this place, and I was like, Mom. I was a little kid, so I need my mom. Take me to this place, please. And I went here, and then I started doing a show when I was a little kid, and I only did like two, three shows, because it was hard. It's hard to do a show. And when I was a little kid, and I was trying to like write stuff and make jokes and everything, and then I kind of gave up on it. And then I kind of, you know, did maybe a few episodes of new shows throughout the times. And then, let's see, September 19th, 2010, I decided to do a radio show. Okay, so then I was doing the radio show, and then I was like, maybe I should turn this into a TV show. And I don't write it, and that way it's easier to do.
is that so?
No joke.
That's literally
no joke. Yeah.
So you've been flipping through through a TV guide recently, and also the channels on channel surfing.
Yeah, you can't really channel. I shouldn't be eating. You can't really channel surf anymore because the channels go so slow. It's like with the digital thing, you know.
It's like
you know
load.
How it is. You watch
it's
TV,
like
right?
Load, yeah.
You watch TV?
Oh, many, many times.
I'm not supposed to ask any questions. so you like, it like goes so slow. You can't just be like thing, and so you're kind of forced to use the guide. I used to like the mystery of it. You know, you flip the channels, you don't even know what's gonna happen. It's like choo choo choo, and it went super fast. You can just like, blah, 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 you know. But now it takes like 2 seconds between every single channel. So if you're flipping through 60 channels, that's a whole like minute. And in terms of TV, like a minute's a long time.
True.
So you can't really just flip through the channels anymore. So I don't know. You know, these kids, maybe they're getting longer. Whoa. What's happening?
Oh,
what is that?
I think either thunder has rolled into the studio or a graphic has.
What are we supposed to do?
So it looks like that we write a number on our hand between 1 and 6.
What are we doing? Why are we doing that, Charles? You're the host, right?
Well, I haven't been watching your Daily Hour with me. I don't live in Thurston County.
What are we supposed to do? I mean, am I supposed to? Class people, can I talk to the people in the production room? Is that work, Freddy? Or do they have a mic in there? Maybe they don't. They're being professionals this time. Because oftentimes I like to talk to them and stuff, but huh?
Do whatever I want to do.
So just start telling people what the dice game is, because Charles doesn't know what the dice game is. So Charles, I'll tell you, we're going to play the dice game. We're getting out a pen here. Charles got a pen. We're going to write numbers on our hands between 1 and 6. We're going to try to visualize the future. Charles, is kind of like a game show. This is the game portion of the show.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Charles, this must be fun for you because you're hosting the show where me and Carl and Regan, too, we know the show. You're the host. You don't know the show. Right? that's
yeah,
fun. That's fun.
Yeah, that's true because the show doesn't air in my area.
Yeah. I think I like that. I want to get guests, you know, like other shows. They get guests. But I'm like the guest. I'm getting guest hosts to guest me, and I'm still the guest. I'm gonna invite you to come on my show. You ask me questions, and then I'm just answering all the questions. Is that it? You guys in the studio are gonna get a number? They're gonna talk to me through the crazy intercom thing over there.
Well, here comes the time where we roll a die.
Well, yeah. Tim, the cameraman, can get a number too.
Okay.
No, he doesn't want a number, he says. All right, here we go.
Enough. All right, either way. Am I rolling on the floor or rolling on the desk?
On the floor.
On the floor, okay.
Tim the cameraman's giving his hand signals.
All right,
here we go.
Do
you have a number, Charles?
I do.
Oh, yeah, okay.
What number came up on the die?
It's a 2.
Is it a 2 or 4?
No, it looks like a 2.
It's a 2. I won!
Oh, my gosh.
I got 500 points. Can you see my...
Can we get a close-up of
focus.
A
there is 2. Yeah. That's me. I won 500 points. And they also have a 2?
No.
No, I don't have that number on my hand.
I'm the only winner. Me and... one
or two? Regan?
Well, Dave.
I know your name.
Zilger.
No, Zilger's number 4.
Yeah, Dave, Wanda, Tiffany, Zilger.
Wanda. Me and Wanda, 500 points over there in the family.
Yeah.
We're going to take a look? The family? In front of Charles in the picture.
Picture frame.
Can we get a close-up of the picture frame right there?
Yeah.
It's hard. I'm not supposed to be doing this. I told my... they told me...
I was given no instructions.
Like, you guys are supposed to do whatever you want to do. So I'm. Oh, there it is.
Oh, here it is.
Hey, they got it. Oh, they're doing this thing where they find the shot before and then they cut to it. That's a pro. That's some pro stuff. You know, I'm always like, looking for the shot. Oh, while it's still going.
I'm into.
Well, in defense of the program, though, you can watch this on YDHWM, but. Let's save that for info time, Carl. Jeez, Carl.
Anyway, after we showed a picture of your family there, Rick.
It's the Daily Hour family.
What's that?
It's the Daily Hour family. It's our family.
Oh, our family?
Yeah.
How often do you get to hang out with your family from time to time?
Getting deep with it, huh?
Yeah, because...
I see my family a good amount. I'm happy with the amount. Like, weekly, probably, at least.
Oh, weekly?
Yeah.
What sort of things does your family like to do for fun with you?
We go to Lakewood. I heard you're from Lakewood, right?
Oh, yes, my hometown.
Yeah, we go up there because they got the Korean stores and the BNI. Like, we go up to those Korean stores and shop. We like to watch TV, too. We watch a lot of TV, so... Yeah. Eat food, watch TV. My favorite things. My family's favorite things, too. Maybe I got it from them.
So sort of like my life there.
Yeah, that's what I think most people's lives. Good people, anyway. Not bad people don't watch TV or eat food.
Yeah, because if people don't watch TV too much, then they're probably missing out on what's being viewed.
Yeah, they're missing out on
missing
what's being
out,
viewed,
no.
And they're bad people.
No one's missing out on anything.
Yeah,
we're all here.
You don't think people are missing out on TV when they're not watching it?
Oh, heck no.
Everyone's here.
Well, you can DVR it or find it on YouTube or whatever. So. I'm going to catch up on the political news with a recorded live stream that was aired on, it's probably still airing on YouTube right now, but, nevertheless.
What got you interested in political news there?
Well, it's really kind of exciting to see somewhat of a... It's basically just a really interesting contest of riches. You know, we've got two strong Democratic presidential candidates, and one is kind of more favored to be my favorite, but he doesn't have a whole lot of name recognition, but, you know, my favorite is Sanders, but, you know, Sanders... has held these town halls a lot, and it just gets opinion from the public, and I think that's really inspiring to be able to answer questions directly and to gain feedback from the public rather than to that thing about fracking or whatever. Yeah, I'll talk about Obama or whatever that the other presidential candidate has done. But I mean, she's got name recognition, and so that's all interesting. And I just, I'm waiting until the convention in July. So, yeah.
Interesting story right there.
So yeah, good people watch television.
Yeah, lots of people watch television. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people do, and sometimes there are many shows on TV that got people hooked onto them that they just can't stop.
Like Your Daily Hour with Me.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
Well, you can't stop the Rock.
Can't stop.
Don't stop the Rock.
You cannot stop.
what sort of a genre of television shows do you guys get hooked on easy?
I like reality shows, game shows. I guess a game show is kind of like a reality show.
Kinda, yeah.
Yeah, game shows have a form of reality.
I could answer this, myself. Oh yeah, please do.
Carl. Answer somebody else.
Captain, what is it?
America?
No, not Captain. Space Ghost.
Beefheart?
Space Ghost had his own kind of like Cartoon Network show, and there was kind of like a dead silence sort of thing. Then it's like, okay, changes camera direction and changes the topic a little bit and Zorak and whatever, the people working behind the scenes, and it was kind of a fun, interesting show on Cartoon Network. I remember that.
You got hooked on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, sort of like my life when I got hooked on game shows.
There you go.
What's the best game show on right now?
Oh, gotta be Wheel.
Oh yeah, you still under the Wheel? That's the one you were on. You're still watching
Fortune.
That. Have you seen the RuPaul game show? That's a new one. I forgot what it's called. I'm watching that one too.
Oh, it has something to do with drag, I think.
Well, that's the reality show, but now they have a spinoff that's like more of like a quiz show. Yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen a show like that.
Am I not supposed to ask questions? I know, I ask a question.
You do you, Rick. It's your
show. I'll answer any question at all.
There's no rules. Freddie says
there's no rules.
I feel like there's rules. We got this set and we got these people in there. How many people are in there? I thought there was going to be like a bunch of people in the room like doing stuff. Like they're going to be like running the wires and everything, but there's like less people in the room than I...
Do you want me to shuffle the papers of the studio?
No, I just thought they were going to run around. Hey, did you guys get my Danish? Because I said that I wouldn't come on TV without my Danish. So is there a gopher? Do we have gophers today?
Yeah.
Who are you? Who are you?
What
are we doing here?
Me?
What's going on? Where am I?
Well, my name's
now
Carl.
Now it's info time.
Oh, here comes the segment where we go into info time.
It's an hour-long hyper-life college television drop show that's recorded every night in Thurston County, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, 366 days, and only appears YDHWM again on September 19th, 2010. It takes a weekend in advance, so if you're watching this on TV, you can call 836-434-11, blah, blah.
I went too fast. The text went way faster.
Well, I didn't know if I was supposed to read it or...
You're still going.
Steve Cabral, come on by.
Text went too fast.
105, 104, 40. I love it.
Your daily hour with me.
Yeah, we're back.
And we are back
us,
on the
your
air.
Your daily hour with us.
What else do you guys want to talk about
right
here?
What do I want to do? I have a lot of stuff to do. What about messages? We got any messages? I'm trying. Can the TV hear when you talk? No. Can we look at that box? Is that wrong to turn around and look at the intercom box when it goes off? Because whenever Freddie talks to us, a little light turns on behind the camera. I don't know if we should turn around or if that's like against, you know. You can't hear it. Can I get it? Yeah, here I go. We gotta get this camera turned around. This is behind the scenes, viewers. Whoa, no lights. No lights over here.
Now can you hear me? Can you hear that on the thing, viewers? That's what now I'm talking.
I think it's working, but I don't know. See the lights because of the,
I could see the light on camera.
On the TV though, when I was over there?
Yeah, on the TV.
It was dark, but you can see it.
How about messages? Well, I'm just gonna... just start, if you want to do it, maybe you just start playing them. Because we're not supposed to talk to you so much. Can I ask you some questions, Charles?
Certainly.
This is what I always ask people, but I say, have you ever been on TV before? Because I heard you had already. So.
Oh, yes, I've been on TV. I've been on a game show.
Uh-huh, which one?
Wheel of Fortune.
Oh, yeah, wasn't the new
RuPaul's
Drag Race show?
You were on Wheel of Fortune?
I was on the show.
But did you practice?
Oh, yes, I've been watching its show whenever I can to religiously.
Mm-hmm.
And I also studied the letter strategies and I got to know when to play on and when to stop and bank the money.
Mm-hmm.
So did you bank the money?
Well, at certain point, I knew what the puzzle is, but sometimes I have to spin the wheel and call out more correct letters for more cash.
Yeah.
Wow.
And sometimes if you push your luck too far, you could land on either lose a turn or bankrupt and lose your turn and also your money.
Yeah.
Did you bankrupt?
Well, when they showed the episode, I didn't bankrupt one time. When I was on the show, when they recorded it, at the start of round two, I spun the wheel first, and I landed on a bankrupt, and both of my opponents next to me had also landed on penalty spaces before, and that passed back to me, and when that happened, they had to edit out that part for time constraints.
What? Oh, so they, since you were all losing, they edited it out. What's the surprise? You got any that was on that show, that you wouldn't think we were surprised by?
What I'm surprised on the show?
Yeah, what was surprising, like, when you show up there and you're like, oh, that's weird, I didn't think that was going to happen like that.
Oh, when I first arrived on the set of Wheel of Fortune, it's like I'm in the zone.
Uh-huh. Were you surprised by that zone, though, or?
Like the football zone?
Kind of zones. Not exactly like the football zone. It's part of my happy place.
Yeah, what's the football zone?
Well, you usually when you're like out on the field, you're like in the zone.
Yeah, I think it's a similar zone. I think all these zones are similar zones.
That's when you go in the zone on the field. That's a football field.
That's are you talking when about like a physical zone? Because I think we're talking about like a mental.
No, it's a mental space.
Mental zone.
Yeah, it's the same.
What is this? I keep saying it's zone over and over. It's like that thing where you say words. Like, what was the winning puzzle?
First of all, it's the toss-up puzzle that I solved it, and I solved it with four letters, and I responded Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and I was correct.
Wow!
Wow! With only four letters in the puzzle?
That's right. Four random letters in the puzzle.
Have what was shown? The four letters were shown.
As I remembered correctly, there was an H, a D, a P, and an A, all in the first word.
Damn. Wow.
And you know, when I was on the show, my mother thought that I buzzed in by mistake.
No, apparently you timed that right on cue, apparently.
It's not like Jeopardy, though. If you win the show, you don't get to come back again. Is this like one-time thing?
That's right. But back then, Wheel of Fortune did have returning champions, and then in the early 2000s, they dropped that rule.
Oh, so you didn't get to be a returning champion?
No.
But maybe you could have.
So what'd you win?
Well, I've won some cash, and in my game show announcer voice, a trip to exotic Hong Kong!
No way!
Did you go?
I sure did!
Wow.
It's a fake mic.
You went to exotic Hong Kong?
I did.
Was it exotic?
It is exotic, and...
That's like cultural insensitive called exotic, though, isn't it?
No, it's beautiful exotic.
Yeah.
I'm sensitive to that beauty.
Yeah, I've been listening to the announcer on Wheel of Fortune, and he called it exotic.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Well, anyone that hasn't been to a certain place on the globe, you know, like North America predominantly calls, you know, some other place outside of the United States.
Exotic?
Know, like exotic. Yeah. And, you know,
what'd you
like
do in Hong Kong?
Culturally, like, wow.
Culturally, wow?
Yeah.
Well, when I was
say that.
When I was in Hong Kong, we went on tours, and we also got to go to Macau, home of the casinos, and we also got to see the brilliant light show in downtown Hong Kong.
What's that?
It's where the lights on the buildings flash on, and they flash on in a sequence.
Like the buildings are coordinated?
Yes.
Music?
And they did play it to music.
Where's the music coming from?
It's like a Christmas light show.
We got to see it on boats. Either it came from the boats, or maybe it just came from somewhere that is in charge of the lights.
So I have a question.
Sure.
Maybe you remember when or you've been told or that it went on from like a European sort of occupation to where, you know, the rest of the Chinese go back to, from what I understand, Hong Kong was, one of the places that was under the British Empire, you know, that the sun never set on the British Empire. So when do you know when that, you know, the English kind of removed themselves from Hong Kong? When?
Did they talk about that on any of the tours?
What's that?
Did they talk about any of that on the tours?
Actually, on our on the tours that we got to see many buildings, and we also got to go up on the rail and see many different places, and we also got to go up on a hill, and we get to see a beautiful view of the city.
So the you know, the signage, you know, like the downtown districts, they all had, you know, they were written in Chinese rather than English, or that was kind of like the point that I was trying to get at, you know, that they, you know, moved on back to where, you know, that they were, that the language that they had for thousands of years before British invasion.
Yeah, they did have two official languages in Hong Kong, English and Chinese.
Okay.
Does that answer your question?
Sure, yeah.
Did you eat anything weird there?
Well, I did have some Japanese food and Indian food. And one time I had a potato cutlet that is Indian, and boy, is it spicy.
Yeah.
Well, don't ask for quite so much curry next time.
Yeah,
I
like
guess.
Curry.
Gotta watch
like
out for curry. Those cutlets. Those cutlets.
Oh!
Hey. It's the dice! It's the dice game again, guys!
I didn't expect that.
So, and this time we see two dice at a head rolling by us.
Yes.
Yeah, sorry. Here we go. We're keeping our same number. Let's try to manifest your number.
Let's do this.
Oh
let's
yeah,
do this.
We're doing
do
a
this.
Thing where instead of visualizing, we're like. Like getting like some kind of like a telekinesis or something maybe.
Oh boy!
Right now I'm only with 500 points.
All right, what numbers have come up here?
Another two. I'm winning now. I got 1,000.
Oh my gosh!
Two twos and a three.
Oh, we're getting some waters. I was gonna say yes, please. I was like, almost wanted to say something
sure.
to them and be like, hey, bring me some
Thank
waters,
you.
But I just got it myself.
Thank you.
So it's well, this is a, we're doing this class thing. I said, what are you gonna do after the take this class?
Well, after that, I'm gonna be coming back to TCTV sometime within the next academic year of school, uh-huh. and shoot a pilot of my new high school quiz show.
Why is it a high school quiz show? Why can't it just be all ages? Because we were talking about this a little bit before the show, but I want to be on your quiz show, and I'm not in high school.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but this show is only for high school students.
But
why?
No.
Why?
But
though?
No.
Why don't you just make it all ages? Why high school?
Well, because I've been watching many high school Quiz Bowl shows online, and the Seattle area does not have one here, so why don't I create one?
But why are you doing it there so limited? Why don't you have like maybe some high school and some adult? At least one, what I'm saying is I want to be on the show, but I'm not in high school. I'm going to have to either pretend to be in high school, or you should have an adult day.
Well, I did
have one?
An adult
just one,
day.
Just one adult day, please?
I would say
not
that
like porno.
I would say that adults have too much memorization powers.
Well, that's why you're going to compete against other
adults.
And
it's not fair to the young ones out there.
I think there should be,
you know,
like
the,
a day
the good young ones
it's
out
one,
where it's
one
adults...
Day.
Versus
you,
the high school
you
students.
Teens
could
up
you,
there.
Could you do one
you
day when
participate.
It's not just high school?
It's adults versus the high school students.
Well, during the academic year, I'm going to be doing high school students only. But sometime I haven't thought of doing adults against high school students.
Yeah.
But that should be something to consider.
A teenager doesn't want to run against me anyway.
How long is the academic year though? Can't you just put me? I'm I don't know more than high school students. Just put me in there. I'm just gonna pretend. Like when it starts up,
Kenny's
like,
is it gonna show up?
Is it gonna be tournament style or what?
It's gonna be a tournament style show. And
It's like the same group of people like the whole time.
Yes,
is it battle to the death?
I mean, I'm talking final about 16, it here on TV already, but can I just
to the final four?
Can
and
I just
the
fake
final two?
Just between you and me and the millions of people on watching TV, but can I just pretend to be in high school and then I can get on the show?
Well, we'll see about that, but
I need something firm.
Well,
now.
Well, people are just gonna find out about you after that, and then complain.
Yeah. All right.
They're gonna complain.
Yeah.
You would be cheating.
Yeah,
Kenny.
I'd be cheating.
You'd be
cheating. Too smart. I'm too smart.
Yeah, you don't.
Oh yeah, here's a message, huh?
Oh, we have a message coming in.
Maybe.
Hmm.
Hey, what's that?
Uh oh.
How is that Maui Wowie?
Yeah.
Carl, same question.
I don't smoke, I'm sorry.
We went to the weed store for our art installation, so we told Mr. Ginsu about Maui Wowie, and now he's all about
same
it. What?
How was the Maui Wowie?
That's the same question
you
asked before.
The Blue Dream, or AK-47 here last time.
Mr. Ginsu's encyclopedia of weed knowledge.
Found it. If you find juicy fruit, get some.
I think that those people are making it up anyway. Yeah, they're just like getting the same, growing the same plants, and they're just like this one, yeah. this
you
brand.
You mean like how we talk, make up stuff here on the program?
I'm on my way. That's all I gotta say about that. Get on it, motherfucker.
Oh,
Mr. Ginsu, we're being professional today. Kinda, maybe. Should we call him back, or would that? You think it's okay to call him back? He gets crass. He's a crass person.
What made you say that?
Well, he curses a lot. You didn't hear what
he curses.
It's cursing and
well,
and,
no, that's fine.
About
we can all
marijuana.
Blind ear to that. That's cool.
Just call him and not listen to him.
Yeah. Sure.
I mean,
just
I want to
call him and ignore him.
That's all the messages. So I guess we should call him back, right? Or what do you think, Charles?
Yeah, I think we should. I think we should probably call him back after that.
All right. Can we do that? I guess we're gonna get real answers back from them. It's fun day. Yeah, it's fun day to be here. We were here on those Fridays and stuff, but now we're here on this other day too.
You mentioned.
I feel like I'm really on TV. You know, maybe I felt like I was on TV like every day, but today it's like for real. Maybe because other people are doing all this stuff on this desk.
We're calling.
Hello.
Max and Mr. Ginsu. On the phone?
Hi, can I talk to the studio, please?
What does that mean? Hello?
Your poison.
Can I talk to the studio, please?
Mr. Ginsu? Are you there?
Hey, hello.
Max?
Hello?
Hey, Mr. Ginsu!
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Can I talk to the studio?
Oh, we're glad to have you join us here today.
I'm not going to talk to the studio because you don't deserve it.
What?
Hey, Kenny, what kind of burrito are you eating?
What? Mr. Ginsu, you can see me?
Yeah, I can see you. What kind of burrito is it?
Oh, Jesus.
Is this Mr. Ginsu? It's steak.
It's a what?
Steak.
Steak, huh? Is that like
steak
a fajita type of thing? Like a fajita type of thing, or just the steak?
Just the steak. It's the standard steak. You go up there and you say, I want a steak burrito. It's what they give you.
You ever try that chicken burrito that Freddy gets all the time?
I've had the chicken. I prefer the steak.
Chicken's not bad.
Huh?
I don't know what's going on right now. Is that actually Mr. Ginsu?
This is Maxwell.
No. Oh, it's Maxwell.
Maxwell.
I think Ginsu's there somewhere.
Maxwell from the... from... just the gave us the waters? Air. Max,
yeah, Maxwell from Earth. It's me.
The one that just gave us waters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you just calling... you're just doing like this like learning class phone thing? So you call... to do the caller phone thing?
Exactly.
Oh. How are they doing?
They're doing great.
You give grades...
You give grades after the class?
You play
people
Mr.
People get feedback.
Is anybody failing?
You play good Mr. Ginsu.
I'm not getting no feedback.
Are you going to fail anybody from the class for messing up? Is anybody on the edge?
No,
is that not how, maybe that's not how it works. What
Carl,
do you think?
Don't fail.
Charles, you think anybody's going to fail in the class? You know,
I don't think they are because it's
hard to fail.
This is something you
pay money to go to college, you can still fail.
Yeah, I think this is a class that they can be interested in.
I wonder if this will get feedback.
Max is on the cell phone, he's coming over there.
Yeah, this is going to feedback for sure. No,
I don't hear too much feedback. Look at Max, he's on the phone.
I'm live on the phone right here.
Shall we see
live
him?
Live on the there phone! Live on the phone!
Mr. Ginsu, why are you
here? Here's our caller.
Can Mr. Ginsu hear
our
us?
Our caller should pop his collar.
Did you ask about the burrito or was that Ginsu?
That was me.
Oh, okay, because I was like, Ginsu can't see.
Now there's feedback. Is that Mandy?
No,
Mandy's not here.
That's Regan.
My name's Regan, Mr. Ginsu. Nice to meet you.
Oh, now we're getting back in the room, probably.
Regan.
Megan?
Regan.
Regan with an R.
Like the president, but with an E.
Say it again.
Regan.
God damn it. Say it again.
Regan.
Oh, Regan.
Yeah,
okay.
That's right.
Nice to meet you, Regan.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Ginsu.
What are you doing?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm sitting here eating an ice cream sandwich.
What kind?
Like three different flavors.
What kind? What are the flavors?
Too many Christmas. Strawberry, banana, and vanilla.
Ew. Well, if you mention it,
that sounds gross, doesn't it? Yeah, Charles thinks that sounds gross. Charles is the host. I don't know, the guest host. He's the host today. You want to talk to Mr. Ginsu? Why don't you talk to Mr. Ginsu for a while?
Hi, Mr. Ginsu. What's going on?
Well, like I said, I'm just sitting here eating my ice cream sandwich, looking at my pot plant.
It's my first time hosting it.
No, I'm just looking at my pot plants going, I will grow faster.
Grow faster?
Yeah. I'm seeing some little seeds with some little sprouts coming out the end. And I got some more that are just a little bit taller than that, like 1 inch tall.
What makes you think this should grow faster?
That's a good question.
Because I need them to grow faster. I need them to grow faster.
You need these plants to grow faster?
That's right. I need them to double time.
Well, you know what they say in gardening, you just can't rush a plant to grow.
Why not?
Believe me, my parents have been gardening in their backyard, and it takes time to do a job right.
Yeah.
Well, will your parents do my pot plants for me? Because I need it done right, and I ain't the one to do it right. I've got that much time. My back hurts too much.
Well, not only do they do plants, but they do vegetables too.
Perfect.
Well, they do marijuana.
I don't think they grow marijuana. No.
Why not? It's legal. I need them to.
He's in pain.
It's just not their style.
It's not their favorite.
I get it. I'm just saying. Come on now.
Well, sorry, Mr. Ginsu, but it's just their style.
Do you know what kind of nutrients I should be putting on my plant?
Miracle-Gro.
Yeah, he's
Carl, or is that not your style either?
Besides, if my parents grow marijuana, what would they? I guess the police would find out in a matter of moments.
That's legal.
So, how would it be legal? Right, so 15 plants, but I live in Washington.
Well, it would all depend on the circumstance, because growing marijuana in many places are illegal, and some it is.
Yeah, it's pretty fucking complicated, that's for sure. They don't fucking
really? Really? The commercial from last year, Mr. Ginsu, is your favorite
last
thing.
Last year today.
Commercial.
Your daily hour with me.
It's a commercial. We're here with Carl again, and we talked to Elias. We have a lot of technical difficulties today, and it's fun.
Elias, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
And it is fun.
What's up?
There's a big space behind me, like this.
Yeah. Big Space. Check it out on TCTV.
The Regan, do you have a
phone? 11:30 p.m. and 2 a.m.
What is that sign? What is that sign?
And we are back with your daily hour with me.
Yes, we are. Oh, you should have treat that to a
fine.
A plan.
What's that sign?
Are we playing the dice game? Are we playing the dice game today?
Sure,
or are we
let's
fucking,
play
fucking
it.
It up?
Okay, Mr. Ginsu, we're ready to go.
What are the what was that waving around on the commercial?
Oh. Woo-hoo.
Hey, Mr. Ginsu.
And here come the dice again for another edition
right.
of the dice game.
This is the final dice game.
We're counting on
this
you, Carl.
For all the points. I have 1,000 points right now. I don't think anybody else has any points yet.
You can do it. What you can do it. Dance. Come on. Come on.
Is it messed up? No. Oh.
But
it's all messed up.
I think I can answer your question about...
Okay, what numbers have come up?
Far...
Four, two, and six.
Oh, my gosh. I got one, too.
You got a two?
You got 500
no,
points.
I got four.
Oh, no,
yeah,
you got 1,000
nice.
Points, but I'm the winner. I'm the winner. I got 1,500 points. I beat everybody.
Good
Me
job.
And Wanda.
I'm not even on the board.
Wow. Does that, what does that feel like to win?
It feels good to win. But
now
sometimes,
you get to go to exotic Hong Kong.
Yeah. What do I get for winning, Charles?
Well, actually, it's bragging rights for this kind of matter.
Yeah, I think you're right. Winning's
I'll give
myself.
You a free swift kick.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks,
there you
Mr.
Go.
Ginsu. Hey, I actually can tell you what you were asking about with the your. I'm taking a break from inside of there directing to come tell you what you were waving around and why you were waving something around.
Oh, yeah.
It's because that was when we took down the green screen. So haven't we, like, on the past commercials, it's had, like, the green screen, right, for a long time? Is that what you said? There's a big space behind us.
Oh,
no, wait. Maybe it's just that all the tapes were at Arts Walk.
No, we haven't used the green screen in a long time.
Maybe there was tapes. I thought I knew what it was, but I think it
I
was
think
that
we've
we moved
gotten
all
the
tapes.
Machine in the commercials yet.
Oh,
the
I think you're right.
Machine.
No, it was the tapes that were all stacked up, and then we moved them to the weed store. That's what. It's an urban medicinal for Arts Walk. Maybe that's why there was a big space.
Yeah, I think so.
I think that's what it is. Never mind. Okay, I thought it was exciting.
After watching that segment last year today, doesn't it make you feel that you want to jump in a time machine and go back to that particular day?
We kind of did.
It feels like we did.
I don't know what day that was.
That was
the 26th.
So I don't want to make a verbal commitment.
It does make me feel old, though.
How's the? Can I? While you're here, can practice and stuff.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Thanks, Max, for directing while I'm in here. We got about 15 minutes left. The production is going very good. We're scheduled on TV. We got everything put up on YouTube up to the day. I don't know. The new background tape is working out good. We got to get, I guess we had some technical issues with our first Arts Walk tape, and I still haven't managed to figure out how to get those all resolved, but one way or the other, it's going to be a whole hour. It might be a lot of couch. I don't know. Check
you
it out.
Mr. Ginsu talking through all that, though, right? Or was that on the second day?
I can't remember. I don't remember which day it was. It was one or the other.
Mr. Ginsu, remember when you were talking, like, we were gone, and you just, like, kept talking on the thing? Was that Friday or Saturday?
It was probably Saturday.
Oh, Saturday?
Okay. So that's the day we got... Maybe you should just, even though it's, I don't know.
No, I don't think that, I don't think I could put it on the wrong day. That doesn't feel right.
That would be weird.
Yeah. All right. I think so far we've had one viewer on YouTube watching this one.
Thanks,
so
viewer.
Thanks, viewer.
Yeah.
They were watching. Oh, yeah. I guess it could be someone like previewing the screen.
Yeah.
Don't you think it could be any other people that is on YouTube watching this right now?
I don't know. It could be. They
one other person.
They could try calling in. It's the number is 360-836-4384, and you can get in. Max called in. He was in the studio. He was already in here, but it would work anyway.
He's the one who provided us these waters here.
Thanks for the water, Max.
I'm thirsty.
Yeah, thanks for the water.
Well, yeah, I think production is going good. We got another show coming up here on May 6th. We're going to have a band in the studio. We're going to have Garam playing here, and then it's going to be Dance O Dance with Dreamy Eves. So
right here.
Come check that out here at TCTV 440 Arc Away.
I like
right
to think we should do something that's more like this when we go like back to it, like with the sets and stuff.
Right
and
here.
Less green screen, more
studio.
Sets.
Yeah, the green screen does add a whole nother level of problems and complexity.
And it feels like This just feels like real TV. Like maybe we've been doing this thing that's so crazy for so long.
It doesn't
that
feel like TV.
We're unrooted, ungrounded, or something.
Yeah.
We should get back to groundedness or something.
Yeah, maybe I should get in the groundedness.
You think we should try to ground harder? Maybe we should try to fly higher. Maybe we're doing the right thing by flying higher ground. I don't know.
Maybe we should smoke pot and get higher.
Yeah. Should we fly high? Mr. Gitz is always for getting high.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whee!
You gotta grow. You grow your plants in the ground, and you fly high.
That's right.
What?
Yeah.
What have you? Well, I probably should get back.
All right,
but
thanks, Freddie.
Yeah. Thanks for having
thanks
me.
Thanks a lot, Freddie.
Yeah.
Hello. We got about 13 minutes left. Have you ever been on an hour show before? I mean, I guess Will Fork's only 20 minutes with me, right?
Well, I haven't been on this show before, but primarily, I like to go on game shows.
Oh, you know what you could do? Instead of, maybe you could just call the program.
Fuck.
What?
He doesn't know what's going on.
This guy's doing game shows. Maybe instead of doing, like, you could just call the show, or you should come to the studio, and then you could just ask me and Coral the questions. Can you just come to the Daily Hour show and do your quiz show from our studio sometime?
Guest, so you're doing your show, whatever, and then
not allowed to be on it. I'm too old to be on your show, which I'm not super happy about still. But
or call in from the comfort of your home.
Yeah, you could call. You could just call us, and you could just ask us questions on the phone or something. Would you like to do that?
Well, maybe that could be arranged.
Maybe.
I think it could.
Just don't ask trivial pursuit questions.
What kind of questions? What kind of questions are you going to ask?
Yes,
are they like?
You could memorize the answer.
Are they like math questions?
And then
are you writing the questions?
Remembered the
no,
answer.
I have somebody to write the questions for me.
Who's writing
from
them?
Trivial pursuit.
What kind of topics are they?
Academic and pop culture.
Who's writing the questions?
Damn
well, so, or primarily, I was thinking of a person who can work on my show too. His name is Ken Jennings.
You know Ken Jennings?
Wow.
No, I don't know him personally, but I did know that he won over $2.5 million on Jeopardy.
Yes.
But he's gonna.
It's gonna be a hard question.
You're gonna try to find him, but you haven't found him yet. But you're gonna try to.
It could be difficult, but he lives
in the area, I think.
Yeah, he does live
in
Seattle.
Why don't you get every Monday, Dan?
Yeah, where's Dan? I think Dan is sick. He was supposed to be here today to teach us class, but he bailed. I don't think he's sick.
No, he's sick.
I think he's lying. Are you sure?
Yeah, he was sniffling. He yeah. sounded
he
like you were yesterday.
He just didn't want to teach the class. He
no,
dropped his
nerves. He was sick.
No, I'm just joking.
No, he,
I'm just joking, Dan. If you're watching, I'm just joking.
He sounded really stuffed up.
Yeah, I'm just joking. He just didn't show up to teach the class.
Place.
Like we gave him all the stuff. We're like, here, Dan, take the wave machine,
well,
bring it
no,
to the studio tomorrow when you teach a class, and then he didn't show up.
I picked it up for him, but you kind of studied Ken Jennings a little bit, or the answers to his questions, or. Or the...
I think I could write some really great questions for a trivia show.
Yeah, but if you're gonna be writing questions on my quiz show, come up with questions that only high school students can answer.
I think I could do that pretty easily.
The 2000s.
The chicken or the egg?
Seems like everything I know only high school students know, anyways.
I think they came together,
but they only know about
separately, but
the 2000s. I don't know about 90s pop culture.
Exactly.
Okay. I want to get the question. So you're going to get Ken Jennings to, that's your plan as of now, is to get Ken Jennings, like find him somehow, and then convince him to write questions for the show?
If he's interested, that is, because he may not accept it, because I've been studying about him, and I found out that he's a freelance writer.
Oh, wow.
When is your show going to be on?
I want to submit my questions.
Well, I'm going to shoot a pilot within the next academic year.
What's the difference between an academic year and a regular year?
A regular year is a calendar year that goes to 365 days, and an academic year is where it goes a few days with the summer break.
All right.
So
can I be on the pilot?
Like
is
September.
The pilot going to be part of the tournament, or is it going to be separate?
No, it's going to be separate.
So can I be on the pilot then?
No, I'm going to have high school students.
Why kind of? You just put me on the pilot because then it's going to be the one time shot and then you don't have to do the rest of it.
That's right.
I'm only gonna, yeah, right, Mr. Ginsley? Mr. Ginsley's got my back. I want to do the show.
Kenny feels really like greedy when it comes to game shows.
I want to be on a game show. It's his dream.
It's his dream.
You too pushy?
Yeah,
imagine
right?
that, well, huh?
Wow.
I think anybody could guest on your show and ask y'all trivia, and you could just have a trivia show.
Yeah. Just
anybody
don't ask
could
me
be the
academic
host.
Questions, because I don't know 2 plus 2.
It, are you smarter than Kenny?
I think
2 plus 2 is 22,
one
right?
Of these, you
right?
Can,
no.
You can do the...
you're out. You're
you can do.
I'm out. I'm eliminated.
I think you'll be able to do the quiz show just in the studio. But I want to... I just want like the come on the thing. Yeah, this is like this where I'm showing up and just answering questions and stuff. Against high school.
Would you be able on a game show? Would you be able to not ask the questions?
Yeah.
I'm going to be asking the high school students the questions and then
yeah.
And then
you would have to be quiet.
It's his show, Kenny. He should. Kind of take the reins of
this
show.
I still think you should do high school students is because there's like a precedent. Is that why? Because like there's other shows you watch these shows for high school students. Like, really, but why? Like just because of the precedent, though. But why high school students? About everybody.
Because it is a high school quiz bowl show because it does feature high school students playing on the show.
There's only so many high school students here, you know?
So why high schoolers? Well, because it's a high school show, but why is it a high school show?
Because the kids don't know.
Yeah, why do you
want
to cater to high school students when you
why don't you just call it a quiz bowl show and just drop the whole high school thing?
I didn't come up with a title like that. It is going to be a high school quiz bowl style sort of a show, so it does feature high school students.
But where? Why? I don't. I'm still. You should. I think you
because
should
that's just.
What quiz bowl is something that students participate in that revolves around answering questions around academic subjects and then they press their buzzer to answer and they compete in.
You have buzzers?
Yes.
Where are you gonna get buzzers?
I'm probably gonna find a few things that will allow me.
Where
to...
Where you find them?
where can I
where
find
them? Where they sell them, huh?
Just buy a bunch of taboo games.
No, I can
have buzzers.
But you gotta, it's gotta be like the thing where you stop at the right time. You can't buzz too early, or you get like locked out and stuff.
Actually, I can find buzzers like that online and it's gonna have a lockout mode.
It is. I wanna play.
It's locked, Kenny. Right,
Kenny. I think that this is his project.
Whenever it gets
it's
in
his project.
Kenny really
whenever
wants
it gets
to play,
into it,
though.
You have one day. You can have one adult day. I think you can do
can
it.
Can you please just change your entire project? Can just, you please revolve
just
it around me?
Me. Just
please
around.
Revolve this around me, please.
Yeah. It's okay.
Regan.
Yes.
Don't forget Regan.
Yeah, me and Regan will be on the show too, maybe.
Yeah.
Not the
I feel like up against a bunch of high school students, they would probably just destroy me.
Well, they're really, yeah,
I
they're
like
the
they
smartest
they would know all
students.
The answers.
Where are you even going to get
and
high school students?
Like,
I bet when you actually get to it, maybe it would be like, well, I can't find enough high school students to be on this, so maybe you could...
Not if he told you all the answers before you went.
Yeah, that would be cheating.
Yeah, but we don't want a repeat of what happened. We don't want a repeat of
if
what
you're
happened
making
in the
50s. Show in the first place.
Yeah, I saw that movie, the quiz show movie.
Yeah, Robert Redford.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Yeah, it featured the quiz show 21, and it has contestants Charles Van Doren and Herb Stemple.
Yeah. And what's that guy? What's the guy that played the bowling?
Make it
the bowling guy in Big Lebowski.
He never went.
What's that guy's name?
The Big Lebowski.
Big Lebowski, the guy that played Jesus. The Jesus.
That dude's fucking hilarious.
He's like, I am the Jesus. Remember that?
The dude.
I haven't seen the Big Lebowski.
The dude.
John Turturro. Oh. Yeah, you know John Turturro? He was in the quiz movie.
John Turturro?
Yeah.
I never heard of him.
He was the guy that played the guy that was cheating, right? In the quiz show movie, I think.
Wasn't that Charles Van Doren?
The actor.
Yeah, his character?
The character. He played Herb Stemple.
Oh, Herb Stemple?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's the one who blew the whistle on quiz shows.
And they went
under investigation.
Yeah, John Turturro.
So you know a lot of kids from Debate Club and whatnot.
Well, you know a lot about blowing the whistle on quiz shows, eh?
Yeah, I want to get on the quiz.
Where are you going to get these high school students?
They're kind of...
Hey, Kenny, did you ever participate in Debate Club?
No, I don't want to be in clubs.
I want to know where these high school students come from.
No?
Well, and the high school students are going to come from all over Western Washington.
Oh, wow.
Because there's always so many.
Wow. What's the prize?
How much money are you going to give them if they win?
They're going to get a trophy for their school and possibly a grand prize.
Wow.
And
they better
winning.
Get the money because traveling costs money.
What's the grand prize?
Right. Can you do like a spin-off
winning
show?
Winning is a prize in itself.
Yeah. We only have a few minutes left. We only got like 2 minutes.
Yeah, 2 minutes.
So we're getting down to it.
Heck, clock's counting down to 2 minutes here.
You have any final stuff? We're going to do our final stuff now, right?
Yeah. What sort of final stuff do you guys do on the show?
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank people.
Yeah.
Say final things, like closing words and stuff. You want to come back on the show, Charles? You can come back to our studio where me and Carl are usually at.
Oh, I'd be glad to come back.
Yeah, I've had fun today here at TCTV. We'll be back tomorrow. It feels a little weird that we're here. This is what I usually say the next day. The next day, tomorrow, I'm going to say, like, oh, we're back here. It feels good to be back here.
I
missed it the last time.
Wow.
Double kick.
I did not see that one coming.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Ginsu. Thanks for talking to us today.
Nice to talk to you, Mr. Ginsu.
Glad to have you with us, Mr.
Ginsu. Well, it's nice having you, too. Nice meeting Regan.
Regan. Nice to meet you, Mr. Ginsu.
You gotta think the rest of it, Charles.
Try to make it more about Regan more often.
Thanks, Carl.
Wait, you're welcome.
Carl says you're welcome.
Yeah, anytime I can provide Freddy pleasure.
Says you're welcome too. Dan, try to help.
Anytime I can provide pleasure.
Yeah, I know
pleasure.
He says it's gonna weird. Hey, look at that. It's the end of the show. You wanna
weird.
Read the credits?
No, it's great, I think.
Charles can read the credits.
Yeah, it's your turn to read the credits.
Maybe. This popped up for a second.
We're coming down to a minute now.
Yeah. I think we're going to re-roll the credits here if we look at it.
Is Carl doing his job properly?
Yeah.
Is it the minute, when the minute goes to the end, that's when the credits start? Or is it like the credits are supposed to start now?
I guess. Hurry up, Carl.
There we go.
There go the credits.
Read the credits, Charles.
Right. TCTV channel
22 at 11:30 p.m. and 2 a.m. Or you can watch the
UW. Hey, you were doing good.
Hey, Charles, you're on the crew, right?
I think so. I'll in alphabetical order.
Thank you, TCTV, Cristobal, Lake Bay, Georgia, Fabulous,
Spotify.com, this is Kenny Washington, USA, viewers only.
Viewers like you.
Hell yeah, dog!
Woof, woof, woof.
Hell yeah, dog.
Alright, is that supposed to be the end? Coming up in the next episode of the program.
Your daily hour with me.
Yeah, today Freddie was here in the beginning. We talked to the Department of Ecology about getting recycling VHS tapes and picking up some possibly. Talked to John Webster for a while. We looked at some past stuff. What else, Carl?
I get upset at Hillary a little bit. Eating your young? Ah!
Hillary, she's eating babies?
Yeah.
11:32 a.m. on TCTV, 22. That's some hard
organization. Well, it's not literal.
360-83634. Call and leave a message. You on TV.
Get your mind out of the...
Carl eats a baby!
Yeah. I eat children.